In this video, the first of three in a mini-series called Remembering Guernica, I look at the life of George Steer, a writer, a soldier, and an old Wickhamist. George Steer was born on the 11th of November 1909 in South Africa to Bernard Augustine Steer and Emma Armitage Steer. George's father, Bernard, was a newspaper manager, perhaps foreboding his own son's career. In September 1923, George became a scholar at Winchester College. He is depicted here in his gown, only worn by scholars of the college. At school he was successful, winning an English essay prize. He also edited The Wickhamist, an internal school publication, and was active in DebSoc, the debating society. In 1928, he left the college with a scholarship to Christ Church, Oxford, where he gained a double first in classics in 1932. In 1935, he became the special correspondent for The Times in modern-day Ethiopia, then Abyssinia. He was appointed the day before the Second Italo-Ethiopian War, often referred to as the Italian invasion of Abyssinia. He reported on the war's events, including the use of mustard gas and the bombing of Red Cross ambulances. On the left, we can see Haile Selassie, the Ethiopian emperor, and on the right, Selassie with Red Cross doctors. Steer and Selassie formed a good relationship, so much so that Selassie was godfather to Steer's son with his second wife, Esme Kenyon Barton. George married his first wife, a fellow journalist, Margarita, just before Addis Ababa fell. She would later die in childbirth. Steer was expelled by the Italians as he was anti-fascist. After the expulsion, he wrote no fewer than five anti-fascist books. Caesar in Abyssinia was first, and The Tree of Guernica came second. This is a picture of Guernica after its famous bombing on April the 26th, 1937. The Spanish Civil War, more generally, is crucial in understanding the tactics of the Second World War, because it allowed the Nazis to practice carpet bombing and other novel military techniques. It was also the first war that large numbers of foreign journalists had comprehensively reported on all the details of conflict. George Steer was one of these journalists. In fact, his reports are the reason why Guernica is remembered today. Other bombings of a similar type, such as in Durango, had received little media coverage and are therefore often overlooked. Steer's report about the bombing featured in The Times and The New York Times. Historic Basque town wiped out. Rebel flyers machine gun civilians. Waves of German-type planes fling thousands of bombs and incendiary projectiles on Guernica, behind lines, as priests bless peasants filling town on market day. Later in the article, the reflection of the flames could be seen in the clouds of smoke above the mountains from 10 miles away. Inside the paper, Steer continues to describe the death, despair, and destruction in detail. He blames the Germans, crucially, and says that it is a new type of warfare. Alongside interviews that he conducted, not having witnessed the bombing personally, bomb casings stamped with German imperial eagles made it clear who was at fault. The accusation of involvement was denied by the Germans, but was later proven by a shot down German plane's logbook, which recorded that it had taken part in the bombing. The Germans resented Steer. He was placed on the Gestapo's special wanted list of 2,820 people to be detained when the Germans occupied Britain. Nazi propagandists observed that Times, spelt backwards, is Seemit. Steer later wrote, "A journalist is not a simple purveyor of news, whether sensational or controversial, or well-written or merely funny. He is a historian, and as a historian must be filled with the most passionate attachment, and most critical attachment, to the truth, so must the journalist, with the great power that he wields, see that the truth prevails." Steer was not objective in his writing. he sided with victims. There is a story that he actually fired a gun himself at German bombers during the Spanish Civil War. The Times fired him after his numerous anti-fascist reports, as their editorial stance was neutral on the war. At the beginning of World War II, Steer reported for the Telegraph in Scandinavia, especially Finland. He saw the ruthless bombing of Finnish towns by the Soviets. Later in the conflict, he joined the Intelligence Corps and became in charge of Haile Selassie's propaganda unit in Ethiopia. He actually planned the initiation of action in Ethiopia alongside Sidney Barton, his father-in-law and the head British diplomat during the Italian invasion of the country, and Selassie himself. Their aims of creating a rebellion in Ethiopia coincided with Archibald Wavell's aims. Wavell was a fellow old Wykamist, another scholar. Steer died on Christmas Day in 1944 in a car accident whilst on active service. His writing had a huge impact worldwide. It was directly quoted in the United States Congress and it shocked Western readers, creating anti-fascist, anti-war sentiments. More importantly, perhaps, it was reprinted in L'Humanité, a French communist daily newspaper, where Picasso read it, inspiring his painting Guernica. Thank you for watching this video. If you have enjoyed it, please take a moment to look at my website, godtrest.wixsite.com/cornucopia, for more content like this.